भजता अखिल जेत्र मैत्री भजता अखिल जेत्र मैत्री भजता अखिल जेत्र भजता अखिल जेत्री आत्मवदेव परानपि पश्यत आत्मवदेव परानपि पश्यत युद्धं त्यजत स्पर्धां त्यजत युद्धं त्यजत स्पर्धां त्यजत त्यजत परेष्वाक्रममाक्रमणम् त्यजत परेष्वाक्रममाक्रमणम् मैत्रीं भजत अखिल हि जेत्री मैत्रीं भजत अखिल हि जेत्री जररीं पृथिवीं कामधुघास्थे जननीं पृथिवीं कामधुघास्थे जनको देवः सकलदयालु जनको देवः सकल दयालु दाम्यत दत्त दयत्वं चलत दाम्यत दत्त दयत्वं चलत श्रेयो भूयात् सकल जनानां श्रेयो भूयात् सकल जनानां श्रेयो भूयात् सकल जनानां श्रेयो भूयात् सकल जनानां श्रेयो भूयात् सकल जनानां।
गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल, अ वेरी हैप्पी इंडिपेंडेंस डे टू एवरीवन प्रेजेंट हियर टुडे। It was Mark Twain who said that India is the cradle of the human race, the birthplace of human speech, the mother of history, the grandmother of legend, and the great-grandmother of tradition. Our most valuable and most artistic materials in the history of man are treasured up in India. This Independence Day, let us walk through the grand story of India, the story that we call ours. Many will call India a country. I'd like to call it an emotion, because this country is seeped with history and the voices of the ancestors who lived before us. From ancient history, the Indus Valley Civilization, to the Vedic period, to the advent of Buddhism along with the Mauryan dynasty, the Gupta period, often known as the Golden Age for art and culture in India, and then to medieval history with Delhi Sultanate and the Mughal Empire, especially known for its architectural achievements, which remain UNESCO World Heritage Sites even today, such as the Taj Mahal. Finally, to the advent of Europeans in our country, starting from the Portuguese, the French, the Dutch, the Danish, and of course, the British. What started as a commercial interest for the British quickly changed to an expansionist imperialist policy using subversive politics such as the divide and rule, the drain of wealth, the starvation of millions of Indians, introducing violence and racism, even while Indians contributed their lives fighting for the British in the world wars, the dehumanization of Indian culture and of India itself. And it is from this that we celebrate our freedom. The reason why the names of our freedom fighters are eternal, names such as Subhash Chandra Bose, Rani of Jhansi, Vallabhai Patel, Dalal Bhal Pal, Mahatma Gandhi, the father of our nation, and so many more. Today, we also remember the hundreds and thousands martyred in the fight for independence, the soldiers and the brave common men who knew that enslavement was not an option. But while we remember our freedom struggle, let us not forget what we were fighting for. For we were not only fighting against the British, we were fighting for democracy, for justice, liberty and equality for all people, for the dignity of the individual and unity and integrity of our nation. We were fighting for a sacred document we call our Constitution. This Independence Day, let's remember to uphold our constitutional values. Without them, there is no freedom. Jai Hind.
नन्ही सी हंसी भोली सी खुशी फूलों से वो बाहें भूल गए जब देश ने दी आवाज हमें हम घर की राहें भूल गए हम सोए नहीं कई रातों से जाने वतन सौ चांद बुझे हम नींद उसी दिन आएगी जब देखेंगे
Namaste, my name is Alonza and I'm from the 7th semester BBA class. I hope all of you are happy and healthy on the day we celebrate our 74th year of freedom. I think we can all agree that the Independence Day of 2020 shall remain historically unique because we've realized how united and adaptable we are as a country, no matter the challenges and distance we've all faced this year. As much as we'd like to believe that 2020 has been a bad year so far, let's take a moment to cherish all the good things. Because to appreciate is the most
First
important
off,
thing we've
learned. We saw blue skies and heavier rains after decades because the pollution levels dropped drastically. This year, we also got to know the people who live with us, but ironically never knew well enough. Yes, I'm talking about our families. This pandemic gave us a chance to get closer to everyone at home. And so far, most of us think they're not so bad after all. Further, just a few days back, our Supreme Court gave us another cause to be happy. The court reinstated the ideals of equality and rightfully gave retrospective effect to the coparcenary rights of daughters in the ancestral property. As permanent members of the legal fraternity, I believe this is a celebratory judgment, and what better day than today to do so. And last but not the least, this year, we've also realized that we will unite when necessary. While that may sound cringy to some of you, I have to say that the past few months showcased how impactful we can be as a nation. Despite the intensity of the pandemic, millions of us stepped up and supported each other. This includes each and every one of us as well, from following the government guidelines to adapting to online classes and avoiding social contact at such a young age. You all deserve a pat on your shoulder for it.
Our perception of freedom has definitely changed this year because we're all grateful for life in itself and for the people around us. My dear teachers and friends, please remember, we shall overcome, we shall overcome. Deep in my heart, I do believe we shall overcome someday. On that note, have a safe Independence Day. Love each other, be kind to one another. I can't wait to finally meet you all in person again. Jai Bharat, Jai Hindustan.
Coincidence.
As you chain down my freedom by the words that appease my emotions but not my conscience, I'm watching you. You crowd the streets and light them up with candles while I'm on my deathbed. You demand justice when I'm gone. But when you judge the hem of my skirt while I scale the paths to my dreams, I'm watching you. When you claim the Constitution protects me but expose me to the streets of prejudice because of the darker pigment of my skin, or when I unwillingly fall into the slumbers of caste divide, I'm watching you. When you say I'm free to love, but even after me proving my legality and sanity, I had to hide my identity, sit in the closet, hiding there, I'm watching you. As you climb the stairs of success and reach a higher pivotal, you can't see the sweat and blood that stains those stairs. When the rich sneezes, everyone turns around, but when I die, nobody cares. I'm watching you. As you contend, I'm equal, but when I cry, I'm not manly enough for you. My sufferings are as unnoticed as a blink, and my assault doesn't even get a sigh with tears in my eye. I'm watching you. I see my belongings being washed away. My daughter's school backpack to my toddler's snack as I swim through debris and dead bodies each year to reach safety. I'm watching you. As you have divided my land into segments of hate in the name of religion, as you play a political bait, I'm watching you. I shall struggle to free myself from your epic hypocrisy, from your disguised tyranny, break free from you, dear society, just for once in true sense to enjoy my real independence. I am you. I am me. I'm one amongst the few. I'm also one amongst us. I'm an average Indian, and I'm watching you.
Good morning, everyone. So today I want to do something that showcases the diversity of our country by showcasing my community. So a little bit of context before I begin. I come from Darjeeling, which is famous for its tea, and Darjeeling used to be part of the Kingdom of Sikkim. And as we know, Sikkim became a part of India only on 1975. But way before 1975 or 1947, Darjeeling was given by Sikkim to the British, or rather taken by the British, and Darjeeling has been part of India ever since. Today, Darjeeling is located in West Bengal, adjacent to Sikkim. A little bit of cultural context as well. So the people of Darjeeling and the people of Sikkim, we speak about 70-80% of the population, we speak the language Nepali. Now, whenever I tell people that my mother tongue is Nepali, I'm immediately asked the question, "Oh, so you're from Nepal?" And it saddens me a little bit because I'm not from Nepal and neither were my ancestors. Nepali is a language of the Devanagari script which is common to Nepal, Sikkim, Darjeeling, parts of Northeast and even Bhutan. And even the constitution recognizes it. So out of more than 19,000 languages in the country, there are only 22 official languages of the state, and Nepali is one of them. We also have a lot of freedom fighters from my community. You have soldiers, you have Captain Ram Singh Thakuri, for instance, who composed the song Kadam Kadam Barayaja, and you have Paramveer Chakra recipients, Veer Chakra recipients, and so many more. So it is in honor of them, and it is in honor of the diversity of our country. I show you a glimpse of my hometown in my language.
I'm not afraid to die. देश से है प्यार तो हर पल ये कहना चाहिए। मैं रहूं या ना रहूं भारत ये रहना चाहिए। सिलसिला ये बाद मेरे यूं ही चलना चाहिए। मैं रहूं या ना रहूं भारत ये रहना चाहिए। मेरी नस नस तार कर दो और बना दो एक सितार। राग भारत मुझ पे छेड़ो झंझनाओ बार बार। देश से ये प्रेम आँखों से छलकना चाहिए। मैं रहूं या ना रहूं भारत ये रहना चाहिए। शत्रु से कह दो जरा सीमा में रहना सीख ले। ये मेरा भारत अमर है सत्य कहना सीख ले। इस शक्ति को बढ़कर दिखाना चाहिए। मैं रहूं या ना रहूं भारत ये रहना चाहिए। मैं रहूं या ना रहूं भारत ये रहना चाहिए। मैं रहूं या ना रहूं भारत ये रहना चाहिए।
सलाम
सला चूम लूं मैं उस जुबा को जिस पे आए तेरा नाम सबसे प्यारी सुबह तेरी सबसे रंगीन तेरी शाम तुझ पे दिल कुर्बान तू ही मेरी आरज़ू तू ही मेरी आबरू तू ही मेरी जान छोड़ कर तेरी जमी को दूर पहुँचे हैं हम छोड़ कर तेरी जमी को दूर पहुँचे हैं हम फिर भी है यही तपना तेरे जरों की कसम हम जहाँ पैदा हुए उस जगह निकले तुम तुझ पे दिल कुर्बान तू ही मेरी आरज़ू तू ही मेरी आबरू तू ही मेरी जान मेरे प्यारे वतन ए मेरे बिछड़े चमन तुझ पे दिल कुर्बान
जन गण मन अधिनायक जय है भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मागे गाहे तव जय गाता जन गण